The Thrikkakara by-election results are out, and Congress candidate Uma Thomas won with a record margin. She gained more votes than what her husband P.T. Thomas had got a year ago and surpassed Benny Behanan's record of 22,406 in 2011. Clearly, the Left Democratic Front's calculations went for a toss. To analyze the Thrikkakara results, our reporter G Ragesh, who had been covering the bypoll for Onmanorama, is joining us. Hi, Ragesh.
Hi, Ajish.
Ragesh, we know that Thrikkakara had been a UDF bastion ever since the constituency came into being. However, this time things were a bit different. The entire state machinery, including Chief Minister Pinarayi Vijayan, had made a strong pitch for Dr. Joe Joseph. Even though many predicted a UDF win, such a huge margin was not expected. What went wrong for the LDF?
In hindsight, one could say that the LDF kind of overdid it in Thrikkakara. This lure of a century, or to score a century in the assembly, kind of went to their head, and they tried everything possible to wrest the constituency from the Congress. Ajish, in all public meetings and election rallies, the LDF projected itself as a champion of development, especially highlighting the Silver Line project and other development projects they had initiated. But in the back room, or on the ground zero, they had also engaged in some real politic. To make it clear, what we hear from the ground is that they had tried to galvanize the support of different communities by employing ministers and MLAs belonging to that particular community in areas where a particular community is dominant. The left camp would never agree with us, but we should say there were even some dirty campaign by projecting the Congress candidate Uma Thomas' religion and the kind of issues her husband P.T. Thomas had with the clergy. So I think the left front was hoping to win this election with the support of the Christian community, which comes around 38% in Thrikkakara. But now, when the results are out, we can clearly see that strategy has gone wrong.
We had planned it big, but it backfired, right, Ragesh?
Yeah, exactly.
And is the Silver Line project a major reason? But I was pitching the development agenda with KRA, but did it also backfire?
See, in the initial stage of the campaign, that means even before the candidate was announced, there was a deliberate attempt to make Silver Line a poll plank in Thrikkakara. Apparently, after sensing that the Silver Line issue wouldn't help them make much gain in Thrikkakara, the LDF had indeed downplayed that issue. It was amid this campaign that the LDF government decided to stop the ongoing physical survey related to the Silver Line project. I must say it was a smart move, because they didn't want to create unnecessary, because we had seen a lot of public protests and issues relating to this stone laying procedure. But their decision to do away with the physical survey procedure during this campaign looked like backtracking from their aggressive push for the Silver Line project. But what I hear from Congress sources is that they had actually conducted a survey before their campaign about the Silver Line project.
Okay.
And the result they got was in favor of their stance, which is anti-Silver Line. And looking at the result, we could say that Silver Line was either not a big issue during the campaign, or as the UDF wants to project the Thrikkakara, the mandate in Thrikkakara is kind of against the project.
And another factor we noticed this election, Ragesh, was that the voter turnout was less than last time. Some even thought that this could negatively impact Uma Thomas's tally of votes. But we saw that the exact opposite happened. Which factors came into play?
After the voting day, we had spoken to the representatives of both the Congress as well as the CPM. Then surprisingly, both of them listed out similar reasons for the dip in the voter turnout. One reason they said was that the voters list was not actually updated because it contained the names of people who had died after the 2021 election. And also both the CPM and Congress also said there were some 60,000 or 18,000 people who are out of station. So these factors would have contributed to the dip in the voter turnout.
What was the impact that 2020 and Aam Aadmi Party had on this poll results?
In 2021, the 2020 party alone polled a little over than 10% of votes in Thrikkakara. And at least a minor section of the voters who supported the 2020 last time, they might have stayed away from the voting this time. That also would have contributed to the dip in the voter turnout. What I hear from the Congress camp is that they had kind of a dialogue with the 2020 leadership, looking at the votes that Uma Thomas has garnered. It is also possible that a section of the voters who supported 2020 last time probably voted for Uma Thomas this time.
Also, Ragesh, the BJP was making huge claims. What happened to their votes?
We are yet to get the final numbers, but from what we see now, I think they have almost polled the votes that they got last time. But even the BJP was, surprisingly, BJP was hoping to win some Christian support this time. You must be remembering all the controversies surrounding
G Ragesh.
Yeah. But from the final numbers, we can say that nothing much has happened.
So I think our viewers now have a clear picture on what happened in Thrikkakara. Let's wrap it up. For more analysis and explainers, like, follow and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.